sort of huge attention that's now on them. It's a, you know, it's had a lot of hype around that film. Mm. They're in for quite a ride, do you think? I mean, there's been a lot of focus on them.
I think it's going to be great fun for them, though. Mm. I think it, from what I've never read the book, so, you know.
But they're in for it. They're in for an exciting time. And it must be nice to see one of your friend's children, you know, embrace the world and kind of be known and set out on her steps to stardom, so to speak.
Yeah.
Diana's not come to talk about movies. You come to talk about music.
I'm comfortable talking about movies for sure, but I haven't seen. I've seen a lot of kids' movies lately. You know,
partly because you just explained you've been very, very busy. You're promoting your new album at the moment.
50 Shades of Grey. Oh, is that out now?
Yeah. you're performing in Paris yesterday, and you come back
the day before.
Today.
Yeah, a week. We were doing a week, and we did two shows in Paris playing this new music with David Foster.
So tell us a little bit about the new album, because this is music a lot of people will know, but not necessarily connected to you.
It's music that I'm really familiar with. There's some older songs on there, like Bryan Adams, who I listened to when I was a kid. I was driving in my car on my way to gigs, and I was playing, like, Jamie Cullum. I played a lot of cocktail piano gigs, so I was a bit like Kristen Wiig in Bridesmaids, pulling up with the valet in my, beat-up Toyota Tercel, smoking a cigarette in a Laura Ashley dress, just going, just playing for the wedding, and sneaking out with the cheese tray on the way out, but and then listening to different kinds of music. But there are an obscure song by Bob Dylan. That's the title, and there are some really well-known songs like
the Eagles,
song by 10cc and Eagles. Yeah.
We can listen to one of the songs from the new album. We'll remind viewers of what they may be more familiar with. But let's listen to one of the songs from the new one.
Standing in the smoky haze. I know that you're gonna be mine one of these days, mine alone. Wallflower, wallflower, won't you dance with me? Please let me ride you home.
So that's from Diana's new album, Wallflower. And I was just asking why we were listening to that, if that was almost your indulgence, because the songs, they're very familiar, as Charlie said, to lots of people, but wouldn't associate it with you. And it's very different to what kind of your fans would expect. Why did you choose to... Not, you haven't turned a corner, but you've kind of veered off track a bit, haven't
you? Yeah, well, that's what we do as artists. We just want to do different things and go into a different area, and it was the right time for me. I'd done lots of jazz records and played lots of jazz piano, and I wanted to just be kind of this, being in the role of just being singing and working on songs that I wouldn't necessarily choose if I was accompanying myself, because it's a very different style. Like, for instance, Jim Croce's Operator, sort of intricate piano part. And I've worked with other people before. I've produced a couple of records, and I think it's really important to make sure that you do what's right for the music. So I hire another piano player. Besides myself, I don't feel like I have to play every single part. So the piano player I hired happened to be David Foster. So he started playing, and then he said, well, you should play on this song. And I said, no, I kind of like what you're doing. So we just kept on that thread. So it was really nice for me to indulge in just singing and not worrying about the piano parts and the piano arrangements so much.
Can I just say, I love the fact that you've got a Gilbert O'Sullivan track on there. Yeah. Alone Again Naturally.
Yeah.
I said that in a weird way, didn't I? Alone Again Naturally. Yeah. But that song's another one of his songs that some people might know. Did he ever do any good in America, Gilbert O'Sullivan? Was he just a UK star?
Well, I'm Canadian, so I know that he did. My dad had his record, so I think he was popular in Canada. I think
that was probably
a hit in Canada.
Yeah, was
I know it. I don't have to learn. Excuse me, I didn't have to learn any of the lyrics. These are all songs that I already knew the lyrics for. It wasn't something that I had to sort of like, oh, now I have to learn this song. It was very easy for me to. I wanted to make sure that I was really comfortable, like with Desperado. There's songs that I don't know how I learned. Maybe on the ski hill, because they used to blast music on the ski hill when we were riding the chairlifts, things like that.
When you look at the names of the people you've collaborated with, and when you had this kind of album in your mind, the concept of it was whirring around, did you just think, I'll just call up these people. I can call up anyone I want.
No,
really?
David Foster had to call up.
Really?
Yeah, I was on tour, actually, and we didn't really have a concept other than I didn't want to make a jazz record. I wanted to make a clearly pop record. I wanted to do it the way David Foster produces and sort of lean into that and also to not make it into jazz interpretations of pop tunes. I wanted to keep the integrity of the original melody, original chord changes, and there were a few door slams going on about arguing over, you know, we need a sharp four chord in there. But I really
wanted
to just...
Are you a door slammer? You don't come across.
Well, I wasn't slamming the door. David slammed the door.
You were opening the door.
You were opening the door and making tea.
I slammed a few doors. No, it was really fun to work with him, actually. We worked really well together because we're both piano players, so we just kind of would say, you know, instead of me saying, I kind of need more purple over here, I could sort of say, I want that chord here. But we worked really, really well together. And once we got the idea of what we were doing, that we weren't doing reinterpretations of these songs, we were just going to do basically, reinterpretations, but not jazz interpretations.
We mentioned earlier on a story about you and Barbra Streisand to do. Is it a card playing?
Card playing, yeah.
Why? What circumstances did you play card? Was it poker?
No, gin rummy. But I grew up with my Nana and my family. We all played different versions. I'm from a place called Nanaimo, British Columbia. So we played Nanaimo rummy, which was all different versions of rummy, different rules, and we had cribbage tournaments, and there was lots to do there. So, but it's just part of my family that we played cards, and I was thank God that I knew how to play gin rummy because she's a card player, and she's also an intense worker. So if we're in the studio, like we're sitting here, and we're waiting for a take or waiting for her to fix the mix or the microphone, she's just like, what are we doing? Why aren't we working? So I got the deck of cards, deal the cards, and we played gin rummy while we were waiting. And I would just pray that I didn't have a good hand. You know,
is she a bad loser?
No, but, you know.
You don't want to be beating
Not a bad loser, but no, but she was great to play with. We actually had a really good time, and she posted on her Facebook page that I was a good gin rummy player, so I was like, feel good about that. It's more important than the record that I did with her.
And a lot of people wondering about when you were playing over here, plans to play in the UK?
Oh, I'm in October, I believe, looking ahead. I think we're playing in London, but I'm hoping.
You've got three dates in the UK, September, October, one in Birmingham, two at the Royal Albert Hall, which is a beautiful venue, and it'll be stunning, I'm sure.
Yeah. Oh, it's my favourite time of year to play.
You might get a bit of rest in between, maybe.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to playing the Royal Albert Hall. That's like big deal.
I'd love to see you this morning. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
I really appreciate you having me. Thank you.
Diana's new album is called Wallflower.
We'll be meeting